Hello everyone, in the previous video I have explained you all the concepts of this categories. By clicking on that category you can open a particular products of that particular category, and by clicking on a product you are going to open a single page in which that product will be displayed. So in today's video I will be covering up the topic like entering a quantity in the cart table and the checkout button and the session, how you can like pick up a user ID from your login section, right? So moving up to the next part, for that what I need is I need a cart table. In the cart table I have a four fields: ID, user ID, product ID and quantity. So what I'm going to implement over here is that after clicking on a TV, the list of TVs has been displayed in the front of me. Then after clicking on a buy now, it will be the single page has been displayed of that particular product. So now what I'm going to do here is I have to enter a quantity. Suppose I want to purchase up two TVs of this Acer television with me. So I will be entering here as two, and just after clicking on a add to cart, in this cart table an entry will be, you can say an entry will be made in which the product ID, the current product ID, the quantity will be stored, right? So moving to the this part, what I'm going to do here is it is my buy cart page. The connection has been made over here. So I will make a form over here. There is a submit button, add to cart, the checkout button. This I will make a button. Form tag. It starts over here. The submit button should always be placed in a form tag. If the submit button is outside the form tag, then the form will not be submitted. So enter quantity. Q2Y is the quantity name and input type text. So text and the quantity. Now see, now I have to pick this product ID also in this form. So how I'm going to pick this product ID? Let's check. I will make here a input type hidden. Basically input type hidden is a text box only that is created but it is not been shown, right? So name, let it be product ID, PID, and its value will be $get. Its PID, I will get its value from here. So let it be a text in the starting. So one text box is made in which current product ID has been displayed, and that is inside my form tag. So whenever I am going to submit this form, my two values will be passed. One will be the quantity and second will be the product ID, right? So this I need to not to be shown on my page, but it is mandatory for me. So for that I will make its type as hidden. So it is hidden, right? But it is existed behind my page. If I am going to check this, that it is existing or not. For example, if I am going to click on this Acer monitor, so here the product ID 6 is there. If I am going to like do right click over here, inspect the machine info, then this is my form part. So form part, see the input type hidden is there, then the name is product ID and the value is 6. So this is available in my form tag, but it is not being shown. This is the benefit of hidden tag, right? So add to cart is a submit button and its name I will be giving as add to cart, right? So now the one quantity, add to cart. So the form method is get. So in the upper part, product ID equals to 6 and quantity equals to 1, right? And now I will be going to type a code over here. If not empty, $_get add to cart. Add to cart is also there. So if not empty, $_get add to cart. First of all, I will be fetching a product ID. So product ID equals to PID. Quantity equals to quantity. Then the query part. Insert into cart. User ID and product ID. User ID, product ID, values. It will be a product ID right now. We have a product ID with us, and second is the quantity with us. So here the product ID and quantity, right? I don't need a single quote because both the data types are of integer. So I don't need a single code over here, right? So if MySQL i_query connect query, got inserted. So 3, add to cart. So record inserted. Fine. Record inserted. And if I'm going to like click on the cart table, so one is the ID that is auto incremented. Product ID is 6. 6 was a product ID. And how much quantity I have like input over here is, that is 3. So the cart has been successfully added. So here, if I'm going to purchase any other record, like TV, so TV, Acer television, if I'm clicking on a buy now, I'm going to purchase a 2. So browse. So here it will be product ID is 1 and quantity is 2, right? So cart table is the main table in which all the details of that particular person who is shopping will be available over there. Like if I am going to shop here is, then I have purchased the product ID 6, product ID 6, how much piece? 3 quantity. And of product ID 1, how much piece? 2 quantity. This product ID 6 is associated with this product table of 6th row. Because here the 6 is Acer monitor and here the cart ID will be containing product ID as 6. So here the relation between this cart table and product table is being associated. Right? Fine. So now what I am going to do here is, see, there is one problem here, that how we can judge that which user is been shopping this product. Right? We need to be aware of that which user has shopped on this product. So for that, what I'm going to do here is, I'm going to restrict it as that if I'm clicking on a buy now button. So add to cart will only be available when I will be logging to my website, right? So in buy now, what I'm going to do here is, this is your form tag. I will be putting here as condition. First of all, like I will be doing a login part. So login part. This is 1, 2, 3. So after login, the session will be created. Let's create a session. So for session on the topmost part, I have to write as session underscore start, right? So if select star from login, if username and password matches, and if count is greater than zero, then a session variable with a user name will be made with a value set over there, right? So a session with the username set will be made. So now if I am going to log in over here, the session name will also, the session variable with the username will is also been made. So in the bycard table, I'm going to write here, if I want to fetch this session variable here also, I have to write here as session underscore start. And in this add to cart button, I will be writing if empty dollar underscore session username, if it is empty, then if it is empty session username, then a button will be displayed and here I will place a link over here of the login page, sign up page. So if empty session username, so right now we have a session with us, so it will not, it is displaying me the home page TV buy now. So right now add to cart page is displayed, right? And here what I'm going to write here is the common header part. In the header part also I will write here if empty session username, if it is empty, then login will be displayed. Otherwise, it will display a logout button. So right now the session is being made, because what I have done here is I am just logged over here and I have put my password. So after putting my password, it checks that password from database, username and password it checks from database, then the result is been executed. If it matches, the count will be greater than zero. If count is greater than zero, then a session variable with username will be made and it will be holding a value set in that, right? So here in the header part, I have made a condition over here. If it is empty, if username is empty, then the button will be displayed that will having a value login over there, right? So if the session is not empty, if session is variable username will be having something, then the logout button will be displayed, right? So here after clicking on a logout, I'm taking it to a sign up page and I will place here as log equals to one. So in sign up page, in the topmost script, I will be writing if not empty, let's take it to the home page instead of login page. let's take it to the index page. So in the index page, I will be writing over here is if not empty dollar underscore get log, then session will be destroyed. So log out. We need to start session as well over here in order to access the login part. So it is logout, and we will be redirecting this page to index, right? So now I'm going to explain it with step by step. So first of all, I have clicked on a login page. Now what I'm going to do here is I am just placing my username and password over here, right? So this is my sign up page, right? And after clicking on the submit button, what is going to be happen is that UN will be coming to username, PS will be coming to password, and the query will be executing, which will check that if username and password is existing in the database table, right? If it is existing, then count will be greater than zero. If count will be greater than zero, then a session variable with username will be made, and it will be having a value of set in that, right? So a session will be made and the value will be set in that, right? So if I'm going to log in this, so login successful, session is being made, page is being refreshed, right? So when the page is refreshed, in the header part, I have written over here, if empty session username, I have just logged in into my system and the session variable with username has been created, right? So if empty session username, then the login button will be displayed. But right now I am having a session variable with me, right? So condition is false. It's moving to this part, right? So logout is being displayed, right? And this logout after clicking will taking me to index.php page, in which a query string will also be going along with this log equals to one. So if I am clicking on a logout here, check here that log equals to one query string is also being generated. So after clicking on a logout, it is going to index.php page, and here I have put a condition over here that if it is not empty, if log is not empty, then every session that is being made will be destroyed and it will redirect that page to index.php. Fine. So when the index.php page will be redirected or reloaded, again the header.php file will be again refreshed. Here the header.php file exists. It will be refreshed again. Here the condition, then it will again check the condition. That is, if empty session username, we have just recently destroyed our all session. So condition is true because it is empty. So it will display the value of login over here instead of logout, right? So this way you can implement your login and logout button with the help of session. So moving to the next part, what I'm going to pick here is I want to display the name of the person who has logged into our system, right? So how I will be doing that is in the signup.php page. See, when the username and password is been like the person is been putting in our text box, it has been checked in our database, right? So here the result is having the record of that particular username and password. I will be just calling a function over here, MySQL fetch association, and here I will pass result. So what I will be having with me is I will be having a full name of that person, email of person, and password of that person. So in this session username, I will be putting here as our full name. So instead of set, my session variable, what will be it will be containing? It will be containing full name of that person that is been logged in, right? So in the header part, in this anchor tag, in this value part, I will just echo session username, because right now username is filled with my full name from database table, right? So if I'm going to log in this, so login 123, login, so login successful, okay, and here the login Nitin has been placed, right? So in this way you can just fetch this username of that particular person from the database, and you can just place it in your session variable, and you can display that particular name of that person who has been logged into your system on this header, on this logout, this header file in the logout section, right? So in this way you can just pick your whatever you want to pick. You want to pick your full name, you want to pick the ID. So along with this session username, I will also create a new session with user ID, and I will place ID of user in this user ID, right? So if I'm going to log in this, logout, again login, so 123, login, so login successful. So the two session variable is being created over here. One is the username session variable that contains the full name of that particular user, and one is the user ID variable that contains the ID of that particular user that is being logged in. So moving to the buy card page, I have opened the session underscore start over here, and now I am going to print here as, for the testing purpose, I will print echo dollar underscore session its user ID. User ID. So homepage TV is a TV. So here my user ID has been displayed. One is the user ID. It's the user ID is one. So here in the buy now page, along with my this product ID hidden text box, I will also create one more text box over here, in which I will be placing my user ID. So this session user ID I will be getting over here, right? So TV Acer monitor. So if I am going to right click over here, inspect, see, I have two text box hidden in it over here. One is a product ID that is having a value of 6, and the other is user ID, the Nitin user that has been logged in into my system, and its ID is 1, and this ID I have get it from where? From session variable. So when I am going to submit my form, three values will be passed from here. One is the product ID, second is the user ID, and third is the quantity. So here I will be getting user ID as well. And here I will update my cart. User ID. And its UID, right? Fine. So this product ID is there 6. So if I am going to purchase this 10 quantity, so add to cart, record inserted. And if I am going to browse this, so this is now my cart table, that user ID, username that has its ID 1 has purchased product that has its ID 6, and how much quantity? 10 quantity. So this user ID is bind with my this sign up table, this ID, and this card product ID is bind up with my product table, this one ID, right? So in this way you can make your cart table, right? So next we will be displaying the checkout section, that if I'm clicking on a checkout section, then this table will be displayed in front of me. Instead of user ID, it will be picking, it will be displaying the full name over there. For that, we will be creating a joins. So instead of product ID, it will display the name of product that have ID 6 with them, right? So I think everyone is clear with this bycard page. So moving to the next part, what I'm going to do here is that in the cart page, our ID, user ID and product ID is there and the quantity is there, right? So I will make a checkout page, the checkout page. What I will do is I will just copy bycard.php. Then I will save it as shopping, let it be checkout.php, right? So if I'm going to create a link over here in the buy cart, in the checkout button, I will just create a link of checkout page. Checkout.php. So by clicking on a checkout page, it is been taken, it's taking me to the checkout.php page. So I don't need anything from here, like the PID, this everything. So just I will be deleting the each and every part from here. So I don't need a product name, I don't need a card over here. So only the AST is being written. I don't need this coding as well. For instance, now ASTA, and here the forms exist. So I also don't need this, right? So in the checkout page, what I'm going to do here is I will create a table. And I will display a cart table over here. So ID. User ID, then product ID and quantity, right? So I'm going to display it over here as query. Select star from cart. MySQL fetch association again the table row. I will display it in the table row. So table data, row ID, then it's user ID, product ID, and the last will be the quantity. So if I'm going to refresh here is the table has been displayed. So what I can do here is table water with one and with 100%, right? So this is the table that has been displayed from the database, the cart table that has been displayed over here, right? So what I'm going to do here is I want to display the records, the cart table, because cart table will store all the records from all the users that are shopping from our website. But what I need to do here is that I need to display only that records, only that records of user that is currently being logged in. So logged in is Nitin, and in the sign up table, Nitin has ID as 1. So in the card table, it will show only that particular record which contains user ID as 1, because currently Nitin has been logged in. So for that, what I have to do here is, if you remember that we have created a user ID session variable in a login form. So that particular variable I will be using over here. So the connection is open. As we know that to use a session variable, we need session underscore start at the top of the screen. So I'm going to just open here as it's user ID equals to session user ID. So select star from cart where user ID equals to user ID. So only that products will show which is currently purchased by currently logged in user, right? Because in the query we have written here as select star from cart, we need to search from the cart table where user ID equals to user ID. See, when I'm going to log in over here, it will create a session user ID from the current login information. So current login information is having my full name, email and password. So whenever I have logged in from here, basically the current user ID is stored in the session variable named user ID. So to access this session variable, we need a session start on the top of a page. And here what I have done here is I have placed a query that select star from product. It was a checkout page. So at the top of the screen, we have implemented session underscore start. So here what I have used here is I have fetched session underscore user ID, the one which we have created in the sign up page, right? So user ID has been passed to the user ID variable. So select star from cart where user ID equals to user. So in this way, you can just display your that particular record that for that user that is currently logged into your system, right? So next part is what I need to do here is I need to create a join over here. So joins are the very important part. See, what is going to do here is the cart table is associated with further two tables. How? See, user ID is the ID that belongs to sign up ID. This one. Because whenever an entry is being made in the cart table, it's basically insert user ID over here. And in the product ID, it has been served. It has been written 6 over here. So if I am going to check that in the product table, the 6 is the ID of Acer monitor. So user ID 1 means Nitin. Nitin has purchased Acer monitor, right? So that is basically the card entry that Nitin has purchased the Acer monitor and the quantity is 10. So how we are going to fetch the username and product name from this user ID and product ID? Let's see. So first of all, I'm going to implement it in the inline part. What I'm going to do here is select star from cart, the table from which we are going to map our user ID from sign up table and product ID from product table. So select star from cart. To this cart table, I can give its extra name as C. Either you can refer the cart table from cart by writing cart, or if you have written cart space C, what does it mean? It means that your cart table is assigned a different value, right? So select star from cart space C, product space P, and sign up space SU. Where so cart means where C dot user ID equals to SU. SU means sign up. SU means ID. And C dot product ID equals to P dot ID, right? So from the cart table, from the product table, and from the sign up table, it will pick the data where C dot user ID means where cart table dot user ID will be matched with sign up dot ID. This sign up dot ID, basically, this one sign up dot ID, it will be checking from here, right? So one is the record present over here, and then what it will be doing is and C dot product ID, and C dot product ID means currently the product ID which has been stored in your cart table. So C dot product ID equals to P dot ID. P dot ID means the product ID, right? So this will be a join that we have been looking for. And also I have to settle it as like select star from select star from cart product P sign up view where C dot user ID equals to SU dot ID and C dot product ID equals to product dot ID. And we can put here as and user ID. User ID means now user ID. And we can write here as C dot user ID equals to user ID, right? From the user ID which has been currently logged in into your system will be fetched from this session user ID. And here basically we are just like putting here as that select star from cart product P sign up SU, where C dot user ID equals to sign up dot ID and C dot product ID equals to product dot ID. And C dot user ID means where cart dot user ID will be equals to user ID means this the current user ID which has been present over here, which has been the current user which has been logged in right now. So from there we can just we are just fetching that user ID and we are just displaying the cart table for that particular user, right? So in this way you can just adjust all these things. So here we have fetched, we can just fetch over here like by just like ID user ID. So instead of user ID we have what we have in database, it's basically full name. So full name over here, then it's product ID, so product name, so product name will be over here and the quantity, right? So let's refresh this. There is no product name, user ID has been fetched over here. Product name, it's product name. Is there any spelling mistake what I'm doing over here? Okay, so the P is the bigger one, bigger ones are not allowed over here. So here it comes. Basically it has a join of three tables. So user ID, instead of user ID we can writing here as username, and instead of product ID we will write here as product name. So username, product name and the quantity. So this way you can just your like implement a card, you can place here the edit button, delete button in order to update or delete your card even from here also, right? So this was all about the login part, the session part, then your the individual card entry, right? So this was all about your card menu, right? So here we are having a few menus coming to these menus because we have displayed the categories from the back end. We have done with the login and sign up page, we have done with all this card system, etc. So here it's my home page. So new product, special, odd products, reviews, contact. So moving to this part, I think we are not having this HTML part. So what I'm going to do here is products.php, we will be saving it with new products.php. So this has become the new products.php page. So what I'm going to do here is, like, if I'm clicking on the new product page, so common header. So here it comes, the new products page. I'm going to place a link over here. New products, and same in the case of special in all products. So I'm going to just write over here specials all products, right? So right now I have made only the new product. I have to adjust its CSS as well. So CSS style.css. So which page has been open? The index page has been open. Okay, we can just like check out at the later end. So moving to the new products, if I'm clicking on a new product, the new products have been displayed over here. So here what I'm going to do here is, I will just like, we don't have a category ID over here. So let's start from products, order by ID descending, right? So whatever the latest product that is being added into a database system, it will just displays that product, right? So new project, it's not the new project, it's basically the new products, all the products that are being just added to your website will be displayed over here, right? So specials and all products, this will be the new products, the latest product that has been added into the computer system will be displayed. Then comes the all products. So I'm going to just new products. We can make another copy. So file name should always be in the small letters, allproducts.php. Here, what I have to do here is, you have to just change this line, order by ID descending. So here your page goes. So by clicking on all products, it's basically displaying me the yellow screen. And in case of this one, basically it is also saying that it's Acer Television, etc. So in this way, we can do this. So we have done with the all products. Now coming to the special part, we have made a field of special inside the product table, in which we have just put the dummy entries of the product ID 1 and the product ID 3, right? So by clicking on a special, what I'm going to do here is, I will be making a file as specials.php. So here we go. So by clicking on a special, what I need here is that only those products are being shown where special equals one. So we have a two products with us. So here, where is your query? So here is the display I and the so here what I'm going to do is, let's start from product where special equals to one. So all the products will be displayed in your special part. So how much there is, it's two products. So I think it's the two products that is in display. So this was all about your special, all products and new products. And the context I have implemented in my first video. And I'm going to just log out when I'm going to log out. Again, the section comes in front of me as logging. So I hope you enjoyed the video a lot and you have a thorough understanding of the shopping cart project, how it has been implemented and it has been used. So thanks for watching my video, and do subscribe my channel in order to get all the updates of your programming language. Thank you.